Can you relish that?
Now we're with chef and owner Willen, who's going to talk about his signature burger, which is just prepared for us, the Wild Rocket Burger. So how did you come up with this burger?
Yeah. This burger came about because one of my sous chef and I were traveling around Sarawak, which is where he's from. One of the best meals we had was just squatting by the roadside, eating a Ramly burger. And in Sarawak, because they're famous for their black pepper, there was this different from the KL Ramly burger, there was a secret black pepper sauce.
Can you roast that?
We came back home to Wild Rocket, we started experimenting with the sauce. And I had many friends who would come to the restaurant and say, hey, we want a burger, make us a burger. And now we start serving them burgers, but not to the rest of the guests. And then other people will look at the table and go, what's that? We like to have that. And that's how the Wild Rocket Burger came about.
Oh, so it was by demand.
Yes, and then we were only serving it on Sundays. And Chubby Hubby, the food blog, wrote about it and said that if everybody were to harass the chef enough, he might serve it every day. So people started harassing us, calling us and all that. And then we started serving it every day. And we thought since there's a demand for it, we decided to open Relish, which is just sells burgers mostly.
Can you roast that?
This is making me hungry.
Yep. So why don't we just dig in and try out the Wild Rocket Burger?
Can you relish that?
And I have a way of eating my burgers. What I do is, because it's so big, yeah. So what I do is I actually hold it and then I let the base of the plate sort of hold onto it. Then I will just eat it like that.
Oh, it's
you're not supposed to bring yourself to the food, but then in this case, I think we have to make an exception.
Yeah.
So I always do that.
Show us how to eat the burger. Oh, come on.
It's meant to be messy. Okay. So because you eat it like this, it's going to be a mess. So I put it down and I go.
Oh, that's a very good method.
Mm.
Can you roast that? Can you relish that?
What do I think about this burger? Well, it's not very dry. Patty is pretty good. The juices are still there. And I like the subtle like flavors, how they all come together as well.
You know, I think a burger is good to have a bit of a texture to it. So the sun-dried tomato has a bit of onions. It's a bit sour, so it brings out the flavor of the beef. Mm. And then the peppery sauce. And it's a bit creamy, so it all comes together.
Yeah.
And
there's
the
there's a very local sort of spin on this burger.
Yeah,
it's very
it's an oriental.
I see there's a lot of local influences.
Mm, yes.
And is that because of Singaporeans, just their taste buds? Like they just want something a bit like usually spicy or...
I think that the thing about Singaporeans, we are in a place where we can really appreciate Western food. We understand everything about the French food, the Italian food, and we love our Malay food, our Indian food, our Chinese food. Actually, Singapore is one place where we sort of understand the two sides of the equation and we are able to put it together. I've been to fusion restaurants in the West where they didn't understand local ingredients, Singaporean, Malaysian ingredients, and they put things together, and instead of fusion, it's actually confusion.
Can you relish that?
But because we are in a position to understand both, we are able to put things together and make it better.
What do you think are like the key ingredients to make a really good burger that most Singaporeans will love?
I think what's very important is that the patty has to have good quality meat. Because at the end of the day, the patty is the burger.
It all boils down to the
patty.
That's
right. And then everything else is down to personal preference. You might want something spicy, you might want some jalapeno fries with it, you might want to have some cheese with it, you know, egg, whatever.
Okay.
But the most important thing is the beef patty, and always something a bit sour is good.
Sour?
Yeah, that's why you have tomato ketchup, you know.
Yeah.
And it brings out the patty, I think.
Okay.
So, very important to get the right meat,
mm-hmm.
the texture of the meat.
Yep.
When we make the patties, it's all hand formed.
Yep.
The meat is ground to a certain texture that we specially request for.
Okay.
And the percentage of fat is very important in a burger.
So it's really a science when it comes to making burgers.
Yes, it is. I mean, we take our burgers quite seriously because my generation, we grew up with burgers, A&W burgers, and McDonald's.
Fast food,
And then we reach a stage where we are more discerning. We don't want cardboard as patty anymore. We want real meat. And then we thought, why don't we make a really good quality burger and serve it. And we always have a classic burger like the Wild Rocket Burger, which is where it all started. And then we have the bacon and cheese burger, which you don't mess with it at all. You know, it's just a good old burger. And for the rest, we sort of play with the different burgers. We have local influences. Like this one is actually a Ramly burger. It's inspired by
Ramly burger. Ramly burger.
So it's wrapped with an omelette. And what I have here is something that's not on the menu that I'm trying today. It's a Mexican burger with a chili con carne.
Oh.
So we have a lot of fun playing with different things.
Yeah.
We are going to launch the topless burger soon. We're gonna
What's
have,
a topless burger?
This is no bun on top, so it's like an open burger. And one of it is a Japanese-inspired one with a Japanese rice patty at the bottom, a mirin teriyaki chicken and seaweed, another one is a lamb burger. So it's fun.
For me, the Wild Rocket Burger was definitely a taste that's right up my alley. But if you're a fan of Asian herbs and spices and local flavors, then definitely give the Ramly Burger a try. For the Wild Rocket Burger, the patty was tender and juicy, but eat it quick because once it gets cold, the meat does get a bit dry. What really stood out for me was the burger's special sauce.
Which you're not revealing what's in the special sauce.
I'm very curious about the special sauce, Willard.
All I can tell you is it's got sarap black pepper in it.
Creamy and flavorful, it adds kick to the burger. That combined with the sour taste of the pureed sun-dried tomatoes, I have to say, was a clever combination in my opinion. My rating for this burger?
Beef! What a relief!
3 out of 5.
And you're